Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please arise and remove your caps and join Jeremy Toohey for the City of Arcadia National Anthem.
Welcome to match number 4 in the 2010 Women's CIS Volleyball Championships in Edmonton, Alberta. I'm Charles Parkinson with Erminia Russo bringing you the action courtesy of the Streaming Sports Network. Three matches are done so far in this tournament, and this match between the number 2 ranked Montreal Carabins and the number 7 Alberta Pandas, the home team, will finish today's draw and set up the second semifinal. The winner of this match takes on number 3 Manitoba Bisons tomorrow evening, while the best the loser can do is fifth. Now on paper, it's 2 versus 7, but what do you think about reality?
Well, I don't think that's a true indication of where Alberta would sit in the rankings. They came out of Canada West as the host. They had a start of the year very strong, but had not a great ending, finishing 2-10 in their last matches. But they are a much stronger team than that number 7 ranking would say.
Oh, player introductions being completed here for the Montreal Carabins. It's number 1, Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon. Number 5, Audrey Lavallée. Number 7, Marie-Pierre Murray-Metho. Alexandra Logan wears number 8, Melanie Roy. Number 10, Leticia Chulak. Watch out for her, she's 13. And Nadine Alphonse, wearing 14 for Alberta. Camille Wallace, Jennifer Restall, Caitlin Bucknell, the libero Aaron Walsh. Number 10, that's Tiffany Proudfoot, fourth year player out of Calgary. Number 11 will be Jackie Ellis. She's the center for this team from Mississauga, Ontario. And number 15 is Krista Zubik, second-year player. Lori Eisler, one of the senior coaches in the CIS.
Well, she's been her 17th year as the head coach of the University of Alberta, but she also coached 1 year at the University of Saskatchewan. She is one of two coaches in the CIS history who has won 6 consecutive CIS championships. Mike Burchuk with the University of Winnipeg would have been the second.
She's seen it all and done it all here in these major championships. Olivier Trudel, coaching for the Carabins, high-performance coach, coach of the 09 Fichu team for Canada, so he knows his business as well. And these Carabins, undefeated in Quebec.
Well, yeah, and right now Olivier's record is 191 wins and only 42 losses. That's a pretty good record.
Well, not too shabby. This should be a good one. It'll be interesting to see how this crowd helps this Panda team as they get the opportunity to draw first blood, and they do so straight down the line with Zubik.
Well, talking to some people today, Charles, they said if there was going to be one upset in this tournament, that this might be the match. It's going to be tight and it's going to be close.
Good pass on the outside. There's the big hit from Tuilac, fifth-year player out of Paris, France. And you can just see the heat she can put on that ball.
She really does get up and hit that ball hard. She played for the France junior and senior national team from 96 to 04. So she's got 8 years of international volleyball experience, including what she's played at this level.
So this has got to be a walk in the park for her, as Montreal scores off an errant serve receive. And they take a 2-1 lead over the Pandas here early in set number one. Everything on the line for both teams here. First serve into the net.
Well, that was number 8, Alex Lojen. She was named a first-team CIS All-Star last night. She's the setter for this Montreal team.
Big, big serve. Tuilac goes deep. It's kept alive, though, coming out of the pipe. That was number 10, Tiffany Proudfoot. The tip can't score. Another opportunity for the Pandas. And yes, into the corner. Again, Zubik on that right side. A big presence at 6-1. Oh, and that ball hit a piece of the tape. Good job to keep that ball alive. Great roll shot. Puts that ball to the floor. But Audrey Lavallee, the libero for this Montreal team, showing great composure. Pandas testing the middle. Not successful. Cross-court shot. That's Metho out the sideline.
Well, Metho was a member of the 2009 University Ed team coached by Olivier Trudel. She was a second-team Quebec All-Star, so she's going to get a lot of hits as well during this match.
Back set, one-on-one, hit with authority by Melanie Roy, and right at the end of that, you see she looked at the other team and said, aha, take that.
Well, we saw this with the Laval team in the match number 2. There's so much passion with these Quebec teams, and they have the ability to sustain it, which is interesting, because that can be really exhausting.
Well, you got to come to play, that's for sure. And that little miscue on the right side there from Zubik set a little low into the net. So Montreal opens up a 5-4 lead. Nadine Alphonse causing some trouble on the serve, and a big block there terminated by Valet Vachon.
Well, it was a nice tight block by Vachon, and Wah is 5'10", and Vachon is 6'1", so you better make sure that you're trying to take a piece of that block. You can't hit straight into it.
Oh, there's a quick shot, but it's dug in the back row by Alphonse. Nice regroup from the Pandas. Camille Wallace establishes position and rejects the ball.
Well, nice quick reaction by Nadine Alphonse to dig that quick attack. But Alberta, what they need to do is keep doing like that. Keep hitting away. Attack the Montreal defense.
A hand pass, a little bit of trouble, forces the tip. See if the Pandas can score. No, kept alive, but they get another shot at it. Off the blocker's hands and out of bounds, and the Pandas tie it all 6-6. Nice pass, set to the outside. Oh, that ball is just pounded down to the ground.
Well, that was Marie-Pierre Murray-Matho. She had some serious heat behind that. She was a member of Canada's national juvenile and junior team from 2001 to 2004. So another player with some international experience.
Fifth-year player out of Baie-Comeau. But there is an outstanding dump in the middle of the court that time. straight down. No chance for the defense whatsoever. Textbook play. Nice pass up. Miscue on the offense. Gives the Pandas a chance. Camille Wallace, perfect position.
Well, Camille Wallace coming out of Burnaby, B.C. She's a slim little thing, but boy, did she put some heat on that ball.
Quick arm swing. And at the technical timeout, Alberta up 8-7 here in the first set. Well, so far, it looks like both teams have come to play. Only one serving error.
Well, there's no doubt that both teams have the ability to play at a really high level. Which team is going to be able to sustain that throughout each set? You know, they're going to have to carry that on all the way to 25. With either team losing 2-3 points in a row could be disastrous in that set.
We've seen that throughout this tournament so far, where teams seem to have great energy until the latter stages of each set. Around 19, it's sort of, they run out. One team seems to run out of gas and the other team picks it up.
And we're seeing the teams that have more than just one or two players that can put away the ball are the ones that are having the most success. The teams that rely on just a couple of players, it's tough for those players to be able to play through that for an entire match.
So far, the ball being distributed evenly amongst both of these teams, so we'll see how the storyline unfolds here as we get ready to start the set again. Jennifer Restall, nice pass. Off the blocker's hands and out of bounds, and great power coming from this Montreal team on the outside.
Oh, there sure is. By number 7, Matho, she has serious power in that left side position.
Boy, if your hands aren't in the right place, they're getting blown apart
in
a heartbeat.
They sure are,
yep. Referee signaling, maybe just calm down a little bit. Second service miss for Montreal. Jump serve is high risk, but high return.
For sure, and Matho is known for her tough spin serve there. Wasn't a great toss, it was a little bit behind her head, so she couldn't get right on the ball like she had hoped.
Camille Wallace. Putting Montreal in trouble. Here's an opportunity for the Pandas. Looked like it was out, but it was taken. Doesn't really matter when you've got that woman in your front row, Leticia Chualak.
Well, the nice thing about Montreal, when Chualak is in the front row, they got Matho in the back row. So they're opposite, playing opposite positions. So they've got two heavy, hard hitters in opposite positions.
As you say, lots of experience. Management studies, fifth year, but she's 28 years of age. So been around for
a long
time.
She's been around. She sure has. She's a two-time CIS MVP player of the year. So, in fact, she's going to get probably 40 to 50 sets a match easily.
I love every one of them. Little overpass. The Pandas capitalize on it. Caitlin Bucknell. Katie Buckle puts that ball back. Oh, and they follow that up with an ace serve against Audrey Lavallee. So a three-point lead from the Pandas now.
Well, some of the teams that have success in today's play have been the teams that can serve the ball tough, but also consistently keeping it in play, making the other team earn their points.
Chualak, big, big hit, but it's kept in play. Here's another chance for the Pandas to extend that lead. High, hard, deep, successful, Tiffany Proudfoot.
Well, number 14, Nadine Alphonse for the Carabins. She's 6'1", and Tiffany Proudfoot was able to hit over top of her block because she wasn't able to get the block set properly. It was still moving.
Well, Trudell has seen enough, calls his first timeout, got to settle his team down. They're trailing by 4.
Well, I think the one thing, the Pandas aren't going to be able to outpower Montreal, but what they are going to be able to do is just keep the pressure on them, tough serving, quicken the offense, that sort of thing. They're not going to outpower, but just outplay.
Well, I don't think too many teams are going to outpower them.
No.
As long as you can match them, it's all you need, especially if you can dig a little more. So it'll be interesting to see if the Pandas can sustain the pace that they're on right now. As you say, three sets out of five is, it's tough. You might start strong, but eventually the blockers start to groove on the timing
That's
of
right.
the attackers.
Yeah.
They make some slight adjustments defensively, and then you need to make adjustments on your own side. So another chance for Montreal, and that ball hit with authority.
Wow. I mean, you can hear the strength that she is using on that ball when she contacts it.
Yeah, it's a real thunk, isn't
it?
It's a real
yeah.
thunk. Doug Hossein, the up referee. Andrew Cameron, the down ref. Not needed on that play as the ball sails out the back. That's the third service error for Montreal. Maintains the four-point lead for Alberta. Big spin serve. Quick play, though. Nice force into the middle. That's when it helps to have Nadine Alphonse, somebody who's 6'1", coming in. Superb timing.
Well, Nadine Alphonse has relatives in Haiti, so they were displaced during that Haitian earthquake, but luckily everything is okay for her family.
Well, okay for her family and okay for her as well.
That's
as she
right.
drilled that ball, but another service miss. And we've seen this so far in the tournament, teams shooting themselves in the foot with missed serves.
It is amazing the number of serves that have been missed. We have to find out how many total, because there is a lot.
Well, and these are float serves as well.
Yeah.
You can understand a lot more if you're going for the massive kill spin serve, but on a float serve, maybe not so many. Alphonse putting the ball into play. She is floating the ball, successfully kept in. Force in the middle. There's a chance for her out of the back row. Two in a row, though, and Montreal is not going to make a mistake. Nice dig from Aaron Walsh, the lib, on Alberta's side, but just went over the net. So the gap is closing, 15-13. But this one, off the block and out of bounds. Valet Vachon and DeMetho trying to get their hands on that ball. Too much power, too high. And at the second technical timeout, Alberta still with a three-point lead, 16-13.
Well, right now, we haven't seen a lot of middle attack or quick attack by the Carabins. We've seen a little bit more from the Pandas. So the majority of the balls are the high outside, the back row attack by number 7 and number 13. But that not using that quick attack is going to be detrimental to them as this match goes on.
Well, we know Chulak can hit an awful lot of balls.
Yeah.
It's a question of whether the other side can maintain that same pace. And as you say, establishing a middle presence so that you can isolate on the outside
That's
makes
right.
the outside's job an awful
yeah.
lot easier. Oh, so far, a pretty good game plan for the Pandas, you think?
I would think so, yeah. I mean, they got Montreal doing what they want them to do, which is to set to their outside hitters and set to their back row hitter. Even if it is Leticia, she can't score everything. But now they're able to set their defense against just a high ball offense.
Well, Aaron Walsh, the libero for the Alberta team, trying to get her hands on as many balls as she possibly can. Errant pass, opportunity for Alberta, and beautiful dump, Jackie Ellis.
Well, it was a smart dump. Plus, the fact that you have a 6'1" setter really helps in those situations where the pass is tight. She was the setter for the Ontario Canada Games team where they won the silver medal.
Looked like she saw the middle forming there and just moved that ball around, and here she is putting it outside. Half-speed shot, but this one draws the defense onto the net. So Alberta has opened up a five-point lead, and Trudell is going to go to his bench now. Pam Drapeau is coming into the match. Going out is Valet Vachon. Drapeau, first year, 19-year-old from Joliet. And that ball just catches the end line, but oh my, that was very, very close. Nobody can believe it on the Montreal side.
Well, and that's why there's, you know, they take that chance on those flat float serve, right? You're trying just to catch the end line, just like that one.
19-13. Set to the middle. Montreal returns the favor deep into the Alberta court. The gap is now five. More substitutions coming for the Carabins. Coming out is Melanie Roy, going into the match to serve Kim Beauregard Lepage, another medical student. Lefty puts the ball in play, set to the outside. Transition swing, and that one scores. Murray Metho going cross-court. She missed a couple of those, but that one right on the line.
Really sharp. I mean, though, she had a big block in front of her, but just cut it just on the right side of it.
Oh, and a miscue on the defense that time. Chualak sticking out an arm at the last moment, taking that ball away from Beauregard Lepage. Jennifer Restall, phys ed student. Quick back
set.
Boy, that was really fast.
Well, if they could use that more, they'd be successful. It's a very fast, quick step around.
Pam Drapeau, good vertical there as well. Another substitution. Trudell really trying to change the pace of this game with all of these subs right now. Sophie Bergeron-LeBlanc coming in. Metho coming out.
Putting in some stronger defensive players in the back row, giving his big hitters a chance to just take a breather.
That's the second dump from Jackie Ellis. Boy, and when she puts that ball down, it goes down with pace.
It sure does. It's straight down.
Now, more substitutions taking place here. Erin Brady coming in, defensive specialist for Camille Wallace. See what she can do. 21-16 for Alberta. Deep flat serve, but handled easily. Chualak, too much power. Point Montreal.
Well, the last two sets by Alex Lejeune have been much quicker. A quick to the backside, and now a quicker shoot set to Chualak.
This one's starting to tighten up a little bit. Wow, great cross-court attack. Tiffany Proudfoot, boy, she just hammered that ball. Great vertical.
She sure did. And the thing about Montreal's defense that's interesting is that it's not a very disciplined style of defense. The players are still moving when the Alberta players are taking a swing at their ball. That's going to cause some problems.
A little freelancing on the Montreal side, and Trudell calls his second timeout. Trying to figure out this Alberta offense, get his players to play with a bit more discipline as they're down by a bunch here, 22-17 for Alberta in the first set.
Well, you can tell that Alberta is playing with a lot of confidence. They were upset that they didn't make the Canada West playoffs. Only the top four teams went into the playoffs, six teams, excuse me, and they weren't one of those teams, and they were upset about that. So they've been preparing for this, an extra 2 weeks to prepare for this match.
Disastrous second half of the season for the Pandas.
Only winning two out of, winning two and losing 10 sets. I mean, not a good record for them.
But getting into this tournament on the strength of being the host team.
Right, and they want to prove that they should be here, not just because they're the host.
So far doing that very well, very convincingly. Ball's off the top of the block, but it's kept alive. Force on the back set, but it gives Montreal another chance. And they take the second one and make a point out of it.
Well, the one thing about the Montreal setter, she has confidence in all her hitters. Number four, Bergeron LeBlanc, she just came off the bench. She's got Leticia in the front row, and she sets to number four in the back row. So that shows that she's got confidence in all her hitters.
Melanie Roy coming back into that front row. Defense going out. Oh, and a little miscue off an errant pass that time.
Well, the pass was a little bit tight there. It was tough for Jackie Ellis to do anything other than just try to pop it up and save it.
Looked like it went off the top of her fingers. This serve a little bit easier. The pass perfect. Wow, what a massive kill on the outside. Tiffany Proudfoot, what a set she's having.
Oh, she's having a great match. She's another player with some international experience. She played for the junior national team from 2005 to 2007, so she's used to playing at this pace and this speed.
Little topspin, side spin serve. Causes some trouble. But Chulak, just so much force when she makes contact with that ball.
Well, she just overpowers the block. You might have a perfectly set up block, but she's going to outpower you.
Little miscue there out of the middle from the Pandas, but then a miscue on the other side from Melanie Roy, and that sets up set point.
Well, that's a tough angle to hit that ball. Coming over the setter's right shoulder. It's got to be set out a little bit further, but no excuse. That ball was high enough to be put into the court.
Camille Wallace coming back into the match for the Pandas. They are serving now for set number one, leading 24-20. Deep serve, handled easily, but the block is there. What a great defense to keep that ball alive. But then it's hit out of bounds by Sophie Bergeron-LeBlanc. Alberta shows discipline and is rewarded with a 25-20 first set win.
Well, I think a few people will be surprised by that, but what we said at the top of the match is that sometimes these rankings aren't really indicative because these teams haven't played each other. Canada West, Quebec, they don't play each other once, so it's tough to be able to say that one is two and one is seven. Very similar teams, very similar level of play.
Well, Alberta showing just a little bit better execution. They come away with the first set win, and that's got to fill them with confidence. Tiffany Proudfoot looking very strong there. Jackie Ellis, great setting, nice setting dumps as well.
Yeah. No, Tiffany Proudfoot is having a great match. And for Montreal, Leticia Chulak is having a great match as well, but she can't win this by herself. That's been the criticism of Montreal, is that she was traditionally get about 50 sets a match, but she needs some support there. And she has it in Marie-Pierre Mathieu, but she's not getting enough sets out to her other hitters.
So we'll have to see if Montreal makes any adjustments here. A little action going on.
Interesting.
Thank you.
when we look at the stats from this game, the thing that stands out, Montreal has 5 serving errors. And Alberta, I thought, served a very tough set, and yet only 1 serving error.
Well, it's interesting that the score is 25-20.
Yep. 5 serving errors, 5 points.
Team's very close in many of the other statistics, 10-9 in digs.
Alberta slightly higher in hitting efficiency, but not significantly.
Well, of course, that's to be expected when you have Chulak on the outside. So it's Wallace, Restall, Buckle, Walsh, Proudfoot, Ellis, and Zubik. Squaring off against Vallée-Vachon, Lavallee, Logan, Murray Metho, Roy, Chulak, and Alphonse. Down referee Andrew Cameron checking the lineups, making sure everybody's in the right position. Signals to the libero, it's time to go in. Big set here now for Montreal. Tough serve to start. Oh, and a miscue between Jackie Ellis and Jennifer Restall. Ellis coming back for the ball. Restall looked like she was going to go and then left it.
Well, in those situations, you got to get out of the way and just let your setter take control of that ball.
So a nice start for Montreal. Booming serve. And it's a free ball opportunity for the Carabins. See if they can capitalize.
Oh!
Ah, no problem when you're going outside like that. That's a 3-meter line shot.
Well, did you see how fast her arm swung through on that? That is a nice, fast arm swing.
They're checking that ball for damage. Set up by great serving, nice strong serving. Another big booming serve. Explodes off the arms of the passer, out of bounds, and quickly it's 3-0 for Montreal.
Well, Marie-Pierre Murray-Metho reminds me a lot of Marie-Christine Mondor, who used to play for the Laval team. That big, big, strong spin serve.
The fourth one goes into the net, allows the Pandas to get on the board. Krista Zubik will be the first server. St. Albert. Tough float serve. Boy, both of these teams are just serving rockets at each other. This one, a little easier to handle. Set to the outside, but once again, number 13, Leticia Chulak, putting that ball through the block.
Well, even when you think the set isn't right on the money, she still manages to put that power behind the ball.
She's a force for the outside. And once again, that ball is served out of bounds by Pam Drapeau. She came in early in the last set and stayed in and has played well so far. Jennifer Restall has a chance here. Ball handled easily. Down at the 3-meter line, so Montreal, another chance to swing, going outside.
Well, one of the reasons that works so well, besides the fact that she hit it hard, was the fact that Nadine Alphonse took a blocker with her. So when Leticia went up to hit, she had a nice big seam.
Sets quite fast to the outside, seams all over the place. Opening up the blockers. Oh, and it's one-on-one on the outside. Camille Wallace touched that ball. It was going out otherwise.
Well, the block came down so fast, she couldn't even get out of the way in time. So that's nice timing on the block by Tuchulak.
6-3 Montreal. Early stages of set two. They're trailing 1-0. Here's Proudfoot. Huge hit, but what a great dig in the back row by the libero, Andre Lavallee.
Well, that ball's just set, bump set a little bit too wide for Tuchulak to be able to bring it back into the court. She can only do so much.
9-3 right in the middle. Very quick arm swing. I'm not sure that ball had even cleared the setter's hands, but she was already swinging.
She was in the air before the ball got into the setter's hands.
So there's fast, and then there's Alphonse. Oh, and an errant pass. Very, very deep by Jennifer Restall. And at the technical timeout, it's 8-4 for Montreal. So a complete change in set number two here.
Well, Alberta doesn't want to get any more than this number of points behind Montreal because they're strong enough, right, that they can just continue on this roll and sustain this for the rest of the set.
You're watching CIS Championship Volleyball on the Streaming Sports Network. This is the fourth match of the day. Montreal versus Alberta. The winner of this facing Manitoba in the semifinal. The other semifinal set earlier today. Undefeated University of British Columbia Thunderbirds will square off against the University of Laval. The down referee, Andrew Cameron, is checking the ball. Seems to be removing it from play for some reason. Maybe it was one of those big hits from Tuchulak. It's no longer round. Now it's all right. The ball is entered back into play. Pass taken by the Pandas, off the blocker's hands and out of bounds. Looked like Alphonse was reaching right at the end.
We haven't seen a lot of Tiffany Proudfoot in this second set. They need to get her back in because offensively she was very strong for Alberta in the first set.
Another very quick swing out of the middle from Alphonse. The players are saying there was four touches because the block didn't touch it.
And I think they were right.
Well, they didn't have to argue too much because the ball was hit out of bounds. So an error committed by Montreal, maybe two on that play. And the first net violation. And boy, Alphonse goes quick in the middle. You've really got to commit to the blocker.
You sure do. And the thing is, but the problem with it is it's fast, but it's not set high enough for her. She's 6'1" and can jump. You've got to put, it's almost got to be a meter ball in terms of her quick.
Well, we'll watch for that. Alberta struggling a little bit on their passing. One-on-one on the back set, but what a nice dig by Jackie Ellis. And Alberta rewarded with the finish from Zubek.
Well, number 12, Pamela Drapeau, not able to close that block in terms of keeping it tight to the net, so the ball just was able to dribble down off her right hand.
Deep serve taken at the last minute. Alberta, though, keeps it alive. And again off the blocker's hands by Zubik, and suddenly she's come to life.
Yeah, I mean, they've changed up their offensive style. They're now going more to the right side of the court. Very smart choice.
So now the Pandas trailing by only a single point. Big spin serve, and it's over the net. Standing right there, Kaylin Buckle.
Well, that's what shows you a good, tough, consistent serving can do. Don't let them off the hook. I mean, Tiffany Proudfoot is serving the ball tough, but she's keeping it in play.
See if she can keep this run alive. Yes, she can. Set on the outside. Zubik again. She's a force.
She's doing great right now. Nice one-on-one block on her own, but still manages that nice, tight stuff block.
Well, you talked about the importance of having different players step up for you. Last set, Proudfoot really big. This time, Zubik stepping up to the plate.
Well, it does. When one player starts to do it, then the other players can feed off that right now. Tiffany Proudfoot's been a little bit more quiet in this set other than her serve. But they got Zubik now on the right side.
So Montreal started with a big lead early on. Alberta has clawed their way back and taken over the lead. It'll be interesting to see how Montreal responds to this.
Well, the one thing right now that Montreal has to improve is their passing. That they're able to go back to running that quick front or the quick back set that they got them to having the lead at one point.
Looks like they have different speeds and different heights on their passes to their setter.
Yeah.
Proudfoot going for number four here. Oh, and it just catches the top of the tape. Back row, but this time the libero is right there to dig the ball up. Erin Walsh. But Montreal gets another chance. Oh, and it's a lot of power. Matheau through the blocker's hands.
Well, it was a nice set by Alex Lejeune. Just a nice kind of a rainbow type set. Not too high, not real quick, but put it up for Matheau to get up on top of it.
Great pass inside. Oh, nice quick action. Kaitlyn Buckle. Set was a little low, but good job to keep that over.
Well, yeah, she cut it across her body deep into position one where the defensive player, they can't cover that because they're up higher expecting that sharp angle.
Chulak coming out of the match, so that back row leaves Sophie Bergeron-LeBlanc coming in. So no back row right now for Montreal.
But they do have Matheau in the front row, so that should make up for it. Or
or you can always miss your serve.
Or just miss your serve.
And here is Matheau, the big spin server from Montreal. This time that ball is handled easily off the blocker's hands, but kept alive, swinging for the point. Beautiful back attack that time. Everybody thinking that ball was going the opposite direction. Nice choice from the setter.
Well, Krista Zubik, again, nice choice by the setter, but she's doing her job. She's putting the ball away when she gets the opportunity to hit.
And a very difficult serve from her as well. Ball's coming out of the back row. Another chance in the middle. Oh, this one is blocked. Standing tall right at the net there. Pam Drapeau rejecting that ball. She has an opportunity, steps back, ready to put that ball into play. Trying to give her team the lead as this set is tied 12-12. High back set off an errant pass down the line off the outside blocker. I'm quite sure that Bergeron LeBlanc would like to have that one back. Now they've kept Chulak out of the front row here, so this is interesting.
Which is interesting, yeah. Well, the trainer was sitting with her at the bench, so maybe she's tweaked a knee.
It looks like they're looking at her knee or her thigh. But a miscue from Alberta gives the point to the Carabins, and it's a tie ball game right now, folks. They continue to work on Leticia Tuilac on the sidelines. Short serve. There's Proudfoot coming to life off the blocker's hands.
Well, it's a nice rotation for Alberta here where they've got Tiffany Proudfoot in the front row, and they've got a nice big blocking threesome in the front as well.
And you would think they have to capitalize with Tuilac out of the lineup
right now.
Got to take advantage of this opportunity to build up that lead. Very quick play, rejected. Alberta with a chance here. Back set to Proudfoot. Great dig in the back row by Lavallee. And there's that passion you were talking about.
Well, number four, Sophie Bergeron-LeBlanc, who's in for it to Tuilac. She's just going up and swinging away, but they're dropping the set a little bit. It's not so high, causing some a little bit of miscommunication for Alberta on their block.
So the team's just trading side outs here. High ball set. Oh, and there's a little beach roll. She learned that from you, Army. Or Christine Drakich, maybe.
Yeah, you know what? She disguised it well, too. I mean, her elbow was low. It might have been the first indication, but right in the spot, right in the pot, in the middle of the court.
Call that the donut hole. And there's that set over, but this time, Libero is right there to pick it up. And who's there to put it down but Krista Zubik?
She's having a great game.
So at the second technical timeout, Alberta now with a two-point advantage. Very heads-up play from Aaron Walsh to read that setter, dumping the ball over. That's why you need that kind of mobility from those back row players, especially those liberals.
Well, you know, as a libero, they've got to be, that's their job. That's the only job you have. You've got defensively play those balls.
Montreal sideline, you see they're talking about a lot about blocking, and it looked like hand positions reaching left, reaching right instead of reaching forward.
Well, reaching straight up, putting that and closing the block as well, which hasn't been very solid for the Montreal team up to this point.
Back to the live action. Oh, and there's a nice tip on the outside. The ball looked like it was set well out, but not read well.
Well, and the Alberta defense was actually there, but it was just perfectly placed right in front of her.
So Nadine Alphonse. Oh, look out! That ball is ripped down the line at light speed.
Wow, that was quite the hit. It was set inside a little bit, but by design, they set that ball inside a little bit, and she had lots of line to hit that ball.
Looked like Proudfoot drifted right past the block there and just ripped that ball. See if Matho can return the favor. Block gets their hands on it. And Zubik tries, but maybe to the well once too often. Montreal there.
Well, nice block by Matho on the left side of the court. She got right around that ball with good penetration across the net.
So it's a one-point set here. Oh, out of the back row into the seam. And Proudfoot starting to heat up a little bit.
Well, they've got a nice combination in Proudfoot and Zubik. Both of them are on right now.
Camille Wallace back into the front row for the libero on Alberta's side. handled easily. But there is a little setter stump. Beautiful play that time. Well disguised by Logan.
Well, it was nicely disguised because instead of using a one hand, that she went with two hands to make that dump.
So the defense caught off guard. Huge serve. This one taken easily, and Zubik again off the outside block. And it looks like that block is really drifting, trying to stay with her because she's so far out.
Well, what Krista Zubik did well there was went inside, and then the set was set outside. So she took the blockers with her inside, so they were drifting to get back into position.
So great execution. Oh, and there's an errant pass from Metho. That's an ace serve from the Pandas. And they are the first to 20 here, and we're going to have a substitution. So this is the second of the two power hitters for Montreal are now out of this match. Melanie Ferrand is in. Chulak on the sidelines having an injury attended to. So we'll see whether they can respond.
Well, she looks like she's got ice on her left leg, whether it's her knee or her quad. We can't quite see, but there's no doubt that she's hurt herself.
Little miscommunication out of the back row for Montreal, but they get another chance to swing for it. And it's off the blocker's hands and straight down by Camille Wallace. Jackie Ellis, a good job to save that ball.
Well, it was set a little bit tight, both by the setter and the hitter. Both were tight, but nice to hit by Camille Wallace just off the side of the block.
So Olivier Trudel calls his timeout. This match knotted all the way to about 17 points, and all of a sudden the Pandas have come alive and they are up by four here in set number two. Montreal in all kinds of trouble. Leticia Chulak on the sideline. She is their massive gun with ice on her thigh. And Marie Metho, the other power hitter, struggling. So she's out after an ace serve against her.
Well, and then after that, don't have a lot in terms of that level of play and that power of play in that position.
So Montreal trying to find a way. A couple of players off the bench to see if they can answer this Alberta team. Tough serve, set to the outside. Block gets a piece of it, and it's kept into play. Chance for a point. Looking for a touch is Jennifer Restall, but she's not going to get it. Pam Drapeau. Violation on the Carabins, and that was just a tip ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure what happened there.
Trying to reach maybe for that ball.
Maybe. Probably saw the tip coming and wanted to grab it.
22-18 for Alberta. A little buzz in the crowd here as they get closer to the end. Alberta with another dig. Third opportunity here. Oh, and this one is turned down the line.
Well, there's that inside set again where they're bringing Tiffany Proudfoot inside a little bit. And twice now she's turned it down the line.
Wide open there. It's 23-18. And that ball hit out of bounds. And that's that really quick play from Nadine Alphonse. If it's not perfect, you're in trouble.
Oh, yeah, and they really haven't connected on one yet either.
So set point in set number two. Alberta up 1-0 so far. Goes deep. There's an over bump. Proudfoot with a miss hit. But it scores the point. Alberta takes set number two, 25-18. So, could we have an upset in the making here?
Well, if the Pandas continue to play like this, I would say yes. They just played with so much confidence in every part of the game.
The crowd buzzing.
All right, guys, once again, we've got the 18 back on the court.
It'll be very interesting to see if Metho comes back into the match or Chualak has an opportunity. Looks like she's jumping up and down on the sidelines there, trying to make sure that that quad or that knee is warmed up.
I'd be surprised not to see Metho back out there. Just a little bit of inconsistent play, but you've got to go with your guns, and she's definitely one of them. Whether or not Chualak is healthy enough to go out, that's a different story.
Well, she may give it a shot and see
how it feels.
See how it feels. She's a fifth-year player. This is her last shot.
And this is it. Yeah, you're right. Well, the University of Montreal debuted in the CIS in 1989. This is their 12th CIS tournament, and they've never won the CIS. They won a silver in 2008 and won a bronze in 2009, but have not won a CIS championship.
Well, and they're behind it right now, that's for sure, down 2-0 to the Pandas, a team that got in by being the host.
But I don't think that's really indicative of what their level of play is. Well, the teams get into this tournament. There's 8 spots in the national championships, one from each conference, Canada West, Ontario, Quebec, and the Atlantic. Then the host berth, which is number 5, and then the medalist from the previous championship, that conference gets another berth. So that's how Laval got into this tournament.
Thank you for that technical explanation.
You're welcome. I thought it's important to know how these teams got here, because there are 52 universities in the CIS, so how did they get here?
So a great accomplishment just to earn your way here.
Well, sure it is.
Many players going through their entire CIS careers and never
not
even
get in here. That's right.
Getting a chance to be at the show. Take us through the stats of set number 2.
Oh. Well, there's no doubt that the Alberta 44% hitting efficiency as opposed to the Montreal with 26% efficiency. Blocks for the University of Alberta, 5 blocks to the 2 blocks by the Carabins. Oh, sorry, the opposite way. The Carabins are blocking better than Alberta.
But Alberta, great digging so far.
Digging,
25
yeah.
digs versus 16 for University of Montreal. And normally, that's what the Quebec teams are really known for,
that's
is
right.
their defensive ability.
Yeah, a little bit different style for this Montreal team. Not as strong defensively as you would expect to see a Quebec team to be.
Looks more a bit like a Canada West team, much more offensive, much
right,
more
exactly.
powerful.
Yep.
Well, this will definitely be a test of their character. And Chualak still not in for the Carabins. Obviously, the coach, Olivier Trudel, not wanting to injure her anymore. These players, of course, desperate to get in. They'll try anything.
Exactly, yeah. So it must be bothering her enough that she may be a detriment on the court rather than a benefit.
Alberta starts with a tough serve. See if they can capitalize. Yes, they do. They draw first blood. Off Melanie Roy on the outside. 1-0. This one handled very easily. Textbook play. Looked better timing that time.
Much better timing. They finally connected on that quick attack between Logan and Alphonse.
So So one on the middle on one side, and one on the middle right on the other side as Caitlin Buckle puts that ball down. Proudfoot, a lot of heat on that ball, sets up a free ball opportunity for Alberta. Another time into the middle. This time on the 30.
Well, there's been so much emphasis on Krista Zubik on the right side that it's a nice change up to be going to the middle attack to to Katie Buckle in the middle.
So interesting tactics from Coach Eisler. Fabulous placement from Proudfoot out of the back row. A little roll shot. Everybody in the interior of the court. And that ball on the outside. Yeah. And a change is being made here.
Nice ball control.
Gabrielle Vachon back into play. Oh, top spin, side spin. Too much to handle. Audrey Lavallee, that ball seemed to catch her outside hand, and it was gone.
It was a really nice spin serve going towards and then outside as it was heading out.
5-1 for Alberta. The wheels are coming off for Montreal here. Going to have to regroup quickly.
Well, definitely lacking in service reception. The passing has really gone down, deteriorated since the first set. They don't seem to be playing with a lot of confidence either. When you go through a season 20-0 undefeated, how do you adjust to adversity? Well, they probably haven't had a lot of it this year. Now they're in that situation.
You got to wonder the teams that they're playing against,
sure,
what level those teams are at. And we sometimes see that on the men's side of the equation where teams from Ontario are playing in that league, or teams maybe not as strong in terms of the depth of their league. So they have one or two really tough matches, but Canada West, every match
seems
to be a battle. But Montreal still fighting. And getting the point off the missed serve, closing the gap. It's 5-2. Melanie Roy, third year physiotherapy student, putting that ball into play. One-on-one with the back step. Alberta really executing well. The blockers forced to stay with their players. Seems to be lots of movement there.
Well, that was a nice double quick. Number six, Katie Buckle, came around for the front quick, and Krista Zubik came behind for that quick right behind the setter.
Well, whatever they did, it worked.
It worked.
And now there's another opportunity. Oh, and a little dump shot from Montreal scores the point.
Way from the back row, too. High risk.
Big serve, hit deep. Oh, and there's an outstanding set right out to the antenna. Nicely executed by Jackie Ellis.
Well, Krista Zubik is hitting at about 46% right now for the Pandas, and that's very, very high. You're trying to get to maybe 30, 35, too. So be at 46, very good hitting percentage.
And Proudfoot out of the back row, and you can just feel the confidence with this Alberta group here.
Yeah.
Every single touch of the ball is with authority.
Well, they continue to swing away, and then we saw Tiffany Proudfoot put a roll shot in there. And you know when that's happening, the player is in that zone where nothing can go wrong for them.
So it's 8-3 at the first technical timeout. decent crowd on hand here at the main gym of University of Alberta, watching the home team. Don't seem to be much of a factor, though, for the home team.
No.
They haven't really needed to use the crowd here.
No. Normally, the Pandas get a good crowd in most of their home matches, so they're used to playing in front of crowds like this. They make the semifinal tomorrow night. It'll be great for them to have that little bit of a push against the University of Manitoba, who, if they win, they will play.
So, another change being made by Montreal. Melanie Ferron coming in, Methot coming out, just what we saw in the last set. She struggled a little bit on her serve receive. It's translated into her offensive game, so Trudel going to give Ferron an opportunity to take a few swings at it. And right away, Alberta goes after her. Somehow or other, the ball's kept alive. It's an over bump. Looks like a ping pong game right now. Blocked by the Pandas. This time it's Doug. Oh, what a great one-arm dig to keep that ball alive. Aaron Walsh, terrific play. Will they be rewarded?
Oh,
no, it's hit out of bounds, but great defense.
Well, great defense by the libero, Aaron Walsh, keeping the Pandas in that rally. But really, Montreal is struggling to get anything going offensively right now.
Well, there's definitely been no runs at all. It seems like Alberta has been able to side out at will. See if that changes here. Block gets a touch, but Alberta with another opportunity. Oh, and there's an errant over bump called by the up referee, Doug Hossein, on a double contact. So two in a row for Montreal. Close the gap to 3-8-5. Alberta trying the little tip. It's not successful. Oh, and that's off the block and out of bounds, out of the back row. Fearless attack from Melanie Ferron. 5-8. Julak warming up on the sidelines. We might see her yet. Nice combination. Jackie Ellis to Camille Wallace.
Well, she's been successful when they've been able to get the ball to her. She's not used a lot, but when she is used, she's successful in her attacks.
Well, and here's number 13, Leticia Chulak, back into the match. She went out in set number one with looked like a thigh or a knee problem. Montreal dropped the set, and she is back in, and right away that ball served into the net. So that's got to emotionally give your team a bit of a lift.
For sure it is. And you know what? Now she's in the front row, so it gives Montreal an opportunity to get some of that power back in the front row.
Well, we'll see how she looks on her first takeoff. Ball is put onto play. Oh, and that ball is called in. I can't believe it. That looked clearly out of bounds from where we're sitting. What do you think?
I was out.
So the linesman in the far corner has one call and one call only. Everything is in here. And right away, the Pandas score an ace. It's a little unkind. The ball is traveling so fast sometimes. It is hard for these lines people.
That was being very diplomatic, Charles.
Oh, well, there you go. And the first shot from Chulak is deep and out the back end. And here comes Metho back in. That's all for Melanie Ferron. So Trudel is saying, we're going to go with our starters. If we go down, we'll go down with the team that got us here.
Well, I think you have to.
Oh, and that ball just floating like a knuckleball. Here's a shot for Chulak, and that one is in cross court.
Well, she doesn't seem to be jumping as high, but she's still able to get that heavy topspin on the ball.
Off the top of the block from Proudfoot, but not down. Big dig from Walsh, another chance to swing, and there's Walsh again. Going into the middle, Alberta just keeping this ball alive. And finally, they are rewarded, the block not sealing the net.
Well, there is a big gap between Alphonse and the block. The ball was able to go right down in front of her. She actually thought she stuff blocked it back to the other side, but she wasn't tight enough to the net.
Big block in the middle. Ball's rejected. It's going to be a free ball here for Alberta. See what they can do with it. Back set around the block, and that one scores, and it's 14-8 for the Pandas.
Once again, Krista Zubik on the right side has been so effective for Alberta.
So Alberta, 14-8. And you talked about it early. People were thinking about the matchups here in the first round and felt that if there was one upset that you were going to call here, this might be it. So, once again, showing you were a master at this game, Armenia Russo.
Well, the thing is now, in hindsight, you think, okay, Montreal comes in ranked number 2 out of Quebec. They get a tough draw, drawing Alberta. Laval comes out number 2 out of Quebec and matches up with Regina. You know, so sometimes it just... the way it works out really isn't an indication of where those teams sit.
But full credit to Alberta. They have played
sure.
A superb match so far. Alberta has... Montreal has not played poorly, rather. Except for that play. A little errant serve receive there. And this Carabin team a little rattled.
Well, the thing with Lori Iser, she's going to over-prepare. She's going to prepare to the point that she could, you know, she's playing every part of this game by herself on the sideline, and that's how her teams play. They're very, very prepared for each match.
Well, and their execution has been superb, no doubt. One-on-one on the outside, and there's a stuff block, and again, Krista Zubik rejecting Metho, and Metho has struggled in this match so far.
She sure has, yeah.
And the Pandas 16-8. They've doubled the score of these Carabins.
Well, the thing with the Pandas right now, we've had two players out of three, actually, I would say. Krista Zubik, Tiffany Proudfoot, and their libero, Aaron Walsh, have really played a very good game. But the other players have done their job. They're not making mistakes. They're just doing what they have to do and to keep the level of play very high.
Well, Jackie Wallace got the ball rolling right off the bat in the first set. And, of course, you can't forget Jackie Ellis, the setter on this team, putting the ball perfectly right where it needs to be for her attackers. Making them all look good. So right now it's a well-oiled machine.
It sure is.
Well, it should be oiled. It's an Alberta group.
But I'm pumped.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now the crowd starts to get into it. Jackie Ellis serving the ball. Wow, and did that have a lot of movement on it? Seemed to handcuff Lavallee, and everybody just stood and watched as that ball landed.
Well, it just seemed to die right at the end as the libero went to go pass it.
Olivier Trudel on the sidelines, clapping his hands, trying to get his players excited. Beautiful one-hand save on that play.
Boys, Nadine Alphonse, she can get up there.
Logan giving her something to hit off a very difficult pass. Big attack from the Alberta team, but the dig is not controlled. And once again, it's thumped home. Pandas looking so strong now, 18-9. Just on a roll. Trudell's used all his substitutions. No more to give in this third set. Proudfoot gets behind it, but too hard. Too much heat from Metho on the outside, one-on-one.
That was hit really hard by Tiffany Proudfoot. Credit her, she's in the right spot, just not able to control it.
Well, as you say, they've been well scouted. Set on the outside, ball goes out of bounds. Everybody's looking for a touch. Alberta not going to get it. Montreal trying to get their team excited. Looks like Doug Hossein is going to be talking to Chulak, asking the coach to remain calm. So the administration attended to. Alberta putting the ball into play. Nice tough serve, but an opportunity to swing for Metho. And she seems to be finding her form again, the last two hits.
Yes, it's that cross-court angle that she has that's tough, especially when it's hit a little bit deeper. It's very successful.
Well, they're going to need every trick in the book now as they trail 19-11 to an inspired Alberta team. But it'll be plays like that that get them back. That's a big block right in the front row. Pam Drapeau. There's a double contact, two in a row. Lori Eyes, she doesn't like that at all.
Not happy with that call.
Well, and now we're going to have another little conversation where the referee is going to tell Lori to settle down.
Well, it wasn't pretty, that's for sure, but does it warrant a hands call? What do you think, Charles?
Well, I believe the referee is always right. Unless he's not, of course. But two in a row, Montreal trying to claw their way back in. But that ball under the net. And so the Pandas hit 20. Could this be the fourth 3-0 match in the tournament? I'm sure nobody would have predicted 3-0s all day.
I'm surprised. Out of any match that this one, if it is a 3-0, it's the one I'd be most surprised about.
Well, Alberta serving that ball out of bounds, giving another point to Montreal. Oh, and a very difficult serve. Here's a back row shot. That's Zubik. And very quickly, Eisler is going to call a timeout. She senses her team is getting a little discombobulated.
Well, there's no doubt. They've made more mistakes in the last few, five or six rallies than they have in the first two sets.
Well, sometimes you can see that finish line, yeah. But you can't see the potholes that are along the way. Thank you. Well, Alberta still with a commanding 20-15 lead, but it'll be very interesting. This next point will be huge.
Well, if Montreal can get a point or two here, that's where that tension, that stress comes in for the Alberta Pandas to side out.
Start thinking a little bit too much. See if Alberta can handle this serve, get the side out.
Let's see if she can get the serve in.
Yeah, that would be good to start.
There we go.
Well, it's successfully put in. There's the tip. Oh, and it's in. I'm not sure why Pandrapo left that ball.
She was hoping that thing was out.
Wishing it was out, but her wish wasn't granted. And that's point 21, a huge point for the Pandas as they were in trouble. There's a quick set again with the dig out of the back row. But it sends another opportunity to Nadine Alphonse, and this time she connects well with her setter, Lojet.
And the Pandas had keyed on her in the middle as well. I thought they might throw it out to Leticia Chula, but Alphonse has done well with that quick attack in the last few sets.
So every point now so huge for both sides. One trying to win, the other trying to stay alive. A deep shot, but gives the opportunity to Chulak. Oh, and she scores the point right through the hands of Erin Walsh. And this set starting to tighten up. You can feel the tension.
Well, great set by Mathil from the back court position. She put it on the net, which gave Leticia Chulak a chance to take some big swing on it.
And this is Alyssa Jones' first time into the match for Alberta. Tough serve, going to the outside. Oh, and a big, huge block. Alphonse is right there with Melanie Roy. 3-point spread.
You see a bit of a spark happening on the Montreal side. They can feel that they're getting that momentum back.
Montreal trying everything they can. And it's another stuffed block on the outside. Off Proudfoot's head. Oh, and there's tension in the air here, folks, now as Eisler calls her second timeout. 2 points between these two teams.
Well, I think back when it was 20-15, Charles, you said it, the Pandas could see the end, but they just started to break down a little bit with their passing and then the hitting and then the serve receive. It all started one by one. Wasn't as crisp as it has been.
Well, sometimes it's difficult to cruise home. You've got to fight your way, and for Montreal, they're just trying to stay alive and fourth a fourth set here. So that's all they're focused on right now is just what's happening right now.
Well, for Montreal as well, they've got a nice block with Nadine Alphonse in the middle. That's where they're getting their points.
And Jackie Ellis is front row, so it's allowing the blockers to release a little bit. But that ball served very deep in the interior, off the blockers' hands, but kept alive. There's a control play, another chance to swing on the outside. And that ball is saved. Alberta, another chance. Can they do it three in a row? No! Proudfoot out of bounds. Oh, my.
Well, there's no doubt that Chulak is not at 100% because they're not setting her. Any other match, they would be setting her over and over again, and she's not hitting the balls.
Well, they're feeding off the inspiration of her being out there right now. The dump doesn't work. This could tie it up. Proudfoot again. Oh, three in a row from the outside. Nadine Alphonse has her number, and it's 10.
Well, there's no doubt that she is in Tiffany Proudfoot's head right now. She has stuffed blocked her three times.
Well, Zubik coming in. No change made on the outside, though, even though three stuffed blocks in a row on Tiffany Proudfoot.
Well, I've watched for a setter's dump here because she's been successful with that, depending on what this pass is like.
The pass, not a good one. They're going out of the back row. The block is there again, but they get a chance to reload. Here's Proudfoot. She keeps going, but Montreal keeps digging. Just control play right now. Oh, and that was close to being called on a violation.
Oh,
but Chulak is there, rejects the ball. What a fabulous comeback from Montreal to take the lead now, 22-21, after a huge deficit.
Well, there's just not a lot of flow on the side of the Pandas right now. Everything has broken down, every skill.
Just trapped in this rotation, can't seem to get out. Every single time Proudfoot's hitting, she's getting blocked. Finally, Chulak off the antenna and out of bounds, and you can see a little bit of a struggle there for her up an errant set.
Well, she's almost jumping off one leg right now. She says it's tough to get any pace or any a very good approach on that.
Well, Erin Brady coming in for the Pandas to serve at 22 all, and this is the closest that this match has been so far. Perfect pass on the outside, and that ball didn't go over. Chulak looked like she hit the top of the tape, and she's definitely struggling.
But still, that's a diggable ball by the block coverage there, just not expecting it to come back.
Well, very easy to get complacent when you have her on the outside.
Sure it is.
So a one-point advantage here. Another tough serve, handcuffs Montreal. Alberta going to get a free ball opportunity at it. Going to go middle. No, it's on the outside. A dump. Well, an opportunity squandered as that ball hit off the block and out. Melanie Roy. And this one is tight. Oh, and that ball could have been out. Oh, and finally Proudfoot going outside the blockers, it looked like.
Well, the block is drifting a little bit right now. It's tough for Nadine Alphonse to set it up well.
Well, the white towels are out here. It's match point for Alberta. Nice pass taken, set to the outside, but the block is there. Can they save it? Oh, fabulous save. Another chance here. Again to the outside. This one, Metho.
Nice scramble by the Pandas. Number three, Jen Restall, to keep that ball in play.
Well, it's a seesaw battle here. Teams are trading side outs. Very difficult, serve, and Montreal goes up by 1 point. The bottom seemed to fall out of that serve. 25-24. Nadine Alphonse for the set.
Let's see if she takes a chance like that again. That was a pretty high-risk serve.
Olivier Trudel upset on the sidelines for some reason, having words with the head official. Another serve received, not a great one. That ball off the block and out of bounds, so great nerves on both sides.
Well, smart play by Tiffany Proudfoot to turn on that ball. She's been stuck blocked a couple of times, so she's just trying to wipe off the block now.
Well, she's got the big spin serve. See if she can keep it in here with everything on the line. Oh, and she does. It's very, very close. Ball comes over. And it's hit out of bounds. Oh, no. Nobody can believe it. Chulak arguing with the head referee. The linesman raised the flag right away. I'm not sure what the argument is here, whether it's on the actual hit. Or maybe it's a dump beforehand.
Or maybe she thought it maybe touched the blocker a bit. I'm not sure.
Well,
no.
Whatever happens, she's not going to get the point. Trudell pacing on the sidelines, not happy at all. Match point number two. Handled easily on the serve receive. It goes outside and it's down, but it's kept alive. Huge block, but what defense. There's the right side attack. And it's hit off the block and out of bounds. Krista Zubik. What a match for her. She finishes it off the blocker's hands. Out of bounds, a 3-0 sweep for the Pandas.
Well, right from step one, you could see that the Pandas were confident and ready to play this game. Montreal just wasn't as crisp and wasn't as strong as we expected them right from the beginning of the match.
So the Alberta Pandas, they are advancing to the semifinal against Manitoba with a 25-20, 25-18, thrilling 27-25 victory, 3-0 here in the CIS Women's Championships. So the University of Alberta Pandas advance with a 3-0 victory over the Montreal Carabins. Coach Lori Eisler, player of the match, Tiffany Proudfoot. Lori, they say that you are a preparation expert. They say that you know so much about this other team. How did you prepare for this match?
Oh, I was get a lot of help, and I mean, you just study it, and eventually I think that those tendencies will come out, and in the long run, under pressure, teams will do what they show that they do all the time. It's just knowing them well enough to be able to predict it.
And your players seem to play with so much confidence today. Like, yeah. Where did that come from?
Well, we're a confident team. We're not. We haven't defined ourselves by our record, and we knew that we were going to get better and better as the year went, and we're right exactly where we want to be right now.
So now you go into the semifinal against University of Winnipeg.
Manitoba.
And how do you prepare for them? You played them, obviously, in conference play, and so now you know their tendencies. What do you need to do to take them?
Yeah, well, I mean, the thing is tendencies only get you so far. It's the players doing the things between the lines, and we need to be aggressive with Manitoba, and we really need to get them out of system because they have so many weapons offensively. So, you know, it comes back to serving and defending and trying to counterattack to the best of our ability.
Great. Well, good luck, and we look forward to that match tomorrow. Player of the match, Tiffany, outstanding play, so many kills. Right at the end there, it looked a little tense as they got on your block, but you just kept going and going. How do you feel about that performance?
Well, I feel pretty good. It's tough. But, yeah, it's a lot of fun, and you just have to keep going for it, and you know it's going to come. So.
Well, there was a couple of plays there, especially one on the right side where it looked like you drifted right past the block. You hammered the ball down the line, and that's got to fill you with confidence.
Yeah, it does. It for sure does. I just love hitting the ball, and I love playing this game, so it's a lot of fun.
Well, congratulations. We look forward to seeing you in the semifinals.
Great, thank you.
So it's 3-0 for the University of Alberta, and they are in the semifinals.